prime pick, and especially with this meta, to just go with what's been working for them and what does very well and they're comfortable with. And if they have to be desperate enough, they can swap it to that Warrior Mage Druid.
Yeah, they've been sticking with that Warrior DH Rest of Shaman for quite some time. We're going to see if Mad Dog are able to out-cleave them with the Warrior Ret version, just trading in that DH for their Retribution Paladin. So we're going to expect a pretty high-paced game, in my opinion. Usually Medicleaves versus Medicleaves is going to be like that, and it's going to be just this blood buff of whoever, whichever team can get the most pressure.
Yeah, one thing that's really important to notice, though, is that Mao is actually going for that Spirit Link. He's not going to go for spamming it a lot, but remember, that is still going to give him a little bit of that mana disadvantage, especially because Auction is not playing that, and he has the Retribution Paladin. Retribution Paladins give Blessing of Wisdom. That gives your healer a little bit more mana regeneration, and in long dampening games, that can be the difference, but the only thing that they have to counteract that is the Dog Mage can be playing that Mana Rift talent. That's really important and something that we've seen Demon Hunter starting to do a lot more recently as a way to burn the mana pool of enemy healers, and that way getting that extra pressure. Now we see them going for that onto Oxygen. Fresh does get a nice sink, breaking Oxygen out of the sun, and it gives Oxygen that time to Ghost Wolf, dodge the Mana Rift, and that's going to be really important for them because they want to conserve as much of a mana lead as possible in this matchup.
Yeah, and that's the thing with having Fresh on that Red Paladin. They have the Blessing of Wisdom that sort of counters that Mana Rift, or at least helps to deal with it a little bit better. So it'll be interesting to see which Shaman kind of wins that Mana Rift right now. It's, you know, very early games, so it's not going to matter too much right now, but going into this game, both teams just going to be looking to dogpile a lot of pressure. I would love to see them go for the Shaman more, and we see that Dog Mage is doing that. He's just on top of him 24/7. The Urban Shield Totem is forced as well, just for that. Gets the double stun as well, and I like Dog Mage playing this aggressively.
Yeah, and I do like the preparedness that Mad Dog has. They were going up against Unitas, who was really comfortable playing that Demon Hunter, that Boomkin composition, and it seems like they have this strategy with the Ret Warrior that is actually able to counteract the meta. So maybe if Ret Warrior isn't necessarily meta, if you have something that can counter what's extremely popular, you also effectively have a tier one comp, even if it doesn't do well into other things. So I think it's a very smart choice from them. We could see that Mao is really struggling on mana at this point. He's at 50% mana. We haven't even gone to that dampening mark. We're not really too close there. We should have one more wings coming up from Fresh before we even get to dampening. So with that Avenging Wrath up right now, we have a good amount of time, and Mao really needs to look for a position where he can recover some mana, especially, you know, even if he is holding onto the Spearlings, he's not doing great.
I like this strategy from Mad Dog. Every time they Stormbolt Malby, they also get a Hammer of Justice onto Dog Mage, and that's where the burst damage comes in and where they're looking to get a kill. Both Warriors are playing with that Disarm talent as well, gonna negate a lot of pressure, and there's the fear onto Malpy. Dog Mage could be in some trouble, but an excellent double stun to negate the pressure onto himself. And like you said, ROC seem to be behind in this matchup. There's the Hammer of Justice onto Malpy, a Stormbolt onto Dog Mage, and this is where they're trying to pile in the pressure right now, but it looks like they're gonna be okay.
The one thing that I'm seeing from this, though, is it actually does seem like ROC is able to get a little bit more pressure if they are hitting both DPS. So when it comes down to it, where you have Warrior and DH hitting the Ret and the Warrior, I think that they're actually going to win that damage straight up. So maybe what they need to do is just try to keep that mana a little bit even, try to get Oxygen's mana a little bit lower, and then from that point on, just swap the pressure back onto Fresh. Now, they are getting him a little bit low here. They force the Earthen Wall to him. They force the wall just from Oxygen, so he doesn't really have any major defensive cooldowns outside of the Spirit Link Totem and his Glider's Medallion coming up in 20 seconds. But I feel like going into Fresh might actually be the wisest decision for them. And we've seen Dog Mage actually getting really good mana rifts. We've seen that happening in both series, where even when they didn't have the stun to cover it, he's kind of leading them into those mana rifts that it made it harder for Oxygen, or made it hard for other healers to dodge it. So that's something I really like from Dog Mage's play.
The thing that ROC are doing really well, in my opinion, is they're kind of going after the healer, and then that way they get that triple cleave pressure going in, and it looks like it's much more difficult to deal with than just hitting the two melee. So I think Melpy's actually having an easier time. The double cap to him gets landed, but nothing too predominant to follow it. Stormbolt onto Malpy. Wamfu getting really low during this Hodge. She needs to be careful. Need to make sure they're in that defensive stance, taking as little damage as possible throughout the game.
Right, and we can actually see that we should be getting closer to dampening now that Avenging Wrath is coming back once again from Fresh. So by the time he uses that and maybe it ends, he should have that window where we have dampening, and that's going to matter a lot with Mao going into that with around 20% mana right now. We have Juan getting pressure. They actually forced to die by the sword. That's a bad position to be in, especially once we start getting to that mana where we've been saying that this is really important in this matchup. You play that Red Paladin against the Demon Hunter to counteract the mana rift, try to have that longevity. Now they go for that full fear into a Hodge to the mouth, force him to use that trinket from Dog Mage, a little bit of an overlap, and a beautiful Hex from Oxygen. This is going to mean tremendous pressure is forced out from Dog Mage. He has to use the darkness. So now ROC has nothing. They have no die by the sword. They don't have that darkness available. They force the blur from Dog Mage. This is a really bad position for them, and I think Mad Dog has found a beautiful opening for themselves.
They did indeed. They forced so many defensive corners from that one go and a beautiful hex from Oxygen on the Trinket of Malpe that forced out the darkness. And now they are on the back foot in defensive cooldowns. Just the DH and Wanfu don't even have much to survive on, really. So they're really relying on the Spirit Link talent. There's a full Hammer of Justice on the Malpe. They're trying to pressure him as well as Wanfu, doing a ton of pressure right now. The Blade Storm comes out from Yosuke, but he needs to be careful himself. They don't want to lose this lead by playing over aggressively. Stormbolts onto Wanfu on that Avatar. And it looks like, yeah, Mad Dog are actually taking this due to that pressure, Billy.
Right. They have that lead. I love all of their choices here. And Dogmage is still trying to keep up as much pressure as possible. He goes for that mana rift, gets it onto Oxygen. He is getting the mana a little bit closer to Mao. And I think where things are going to get very important is when we get to this moment, we've seen it with these Resto Shaman teams in these matchups where they're both and then you have to see who's the clear-cut winner. Now, we saw Mad Dog actually win in those situations yesterday, even when it looked dire for them. And I really want to see ROC pull out something, especially considering they just had that window a couple minutes ago where they had to use Dyer of the Sword, they had to use Darkness, they used, you know, overlapped Gliders, Medallions, and that got them so much behind Mad Dog, even though it is more of that slower-paced, methodical matchup coming out here. But I feel like they really need to be concerned and trying to find that final burst window for themselves.
And Mad Dog doing an excellent CC chain there as well onto Malpe with the Stormbolt into Hex whilst the Dog Mage was in the Hammer of Justice. But Wanfu was doing an excellent job disarming the Warriors, timing it to perfection. And now they actually force the Spirit Link coming out of Oxygen. And Dog Mage is going to have the Annihilation in around 10 seconds. So this could be trouble for Mad Dog all of a sudden. And a full fear onto Oxygen, a big World of Glory, going to help keep them alive. But now maybe not force out the bubble or the bop just yet. And Wanfu's getting super low right there. Needs to be careful as well. The Rallying Cry comes out. It's becoming a blood buff. As soon as the Shamans come out of mana and Dampening kicks in, it's all about who can play aggressively the best.
Right, and all that damage did come out from the Avenging Wrath from Fresh, so that's when he's going to get the most pressure available. Now we had Dog Mage using his actual active metamorphoses instead of the ones that are brought to him by the I-Beam. He got a little bit of pressure there, but I think if Mad Dog can actually live until the point where they have that next wings, we saw how much damage they were able to force onto one. We saw the amount of pressure they were able to get. Oxygen again getting a beautiful hex in him out, forcing him to use that Glider's Medallion, but this time we didn't have that overlap coming out from Dog Mage and him, so this is really important. ROC is stabilizing a little bit, but now with that, Double Sun comes out with a full hex onto Oxygen. Oxygen holds onto his Trinket, feels very safe for Fresh. Fresh is holding onto that bubble, does use it, doesn't get too greedy, use it around 20% HP, keeps himself safe. Now he should be able to be topped off, and now they have 1 minute on that Avenging Wrath cooldown, about 30 seconds for Forbearance, and Fresh has to keep himself safe. So I think Mad Dog should be able to kind of live through this, and Mao actually gets a little bit of a drink there. That's going to help him a lot, especially because we have said he's playing that Spirit Link talent. He isn't spamming it completely, but still using it is very mana inefficient. But now that full HUD goes on to one, they need to force the Dive by the Sword. If they can force it without those offensive cooldowns from the Avenging Wrath, that'll spell game for them. They do force it, and now with Avenging Wrath coming up in 40 seconds, it seems like this is Mad Dog's game. If they can keep up the momentum here, they could finish it even before then.
Yeah, they could indeed. And ROC is just falling further behind now. Disarm onto Wanfu. He has nothing to survive with. Maybe he only has that Spirit Link talent, but like I said, as soon as he's out of mana, he won't be able to use it, and it could be huge trouble for them. Fresh and Yosuke just doing as much pressure as possible. There's a Hammer of Justice on the Malpe, the Stormbolt on the Dog Mage, and they're getting as much pressure as possible. He actually hexes Dog Mage. I would have loved to have seen the hex onto Malpe there, but I don't think he was in range. He was just doing what he could. A nice Double Stun coming out from Dog Mage. They're trying to counter pressure every time. I love to see Dog Mage go onto Oxygen and trying to force the split pressure, but it looks like it could be too little too late. Fresh actually getting dropped down using the Blessing of Protection. Malpe is unable to purge it off right now. He has such little mana, maybe he doesn't want to risk it.
But this is Wings. They have a lot of damage here. This is where the counter pressure needs to start from Mad Dog, and they have the Double Stun. They need to finish Juan right now. They have the full Hex coming out. Beautiful play from Oxygen. They're trying to put that pressure on him. They force the Darkness. They're going through the Darkness. 2% HP, and he goes down. Beautiful execution from Mad Dog, turning that game around. Clean execution for them all around.
There you go. We told you, don't underestimate Mad Dog.
Yeah, I feel like Mad Dog, I think they're playing really well. They're adapting well together. We could see that Oxygen and Fresh, they have actually played together for years, and it's quite interesting to see them do well together. They have a great team with Yosk. I think he was the missing member for a lot of them. They would play on the Australian region, and they wouldn't really have a Hunter player that was up to par because Yosk would still play on the North American servers. Now playing with them, excellent addition because Yosk also plays that Warrior phenomenally. He plays the Prop Paladin if he ever needs to bring it out. He's probably one of the best Prop Paladins in that scenario, but he is obviously holding it for, you know, whatever desperate situation. I still think that they're doing really well, and I think ROC's pick is what's probably going to put them behind outside of what you're saying, using this map so that they can get that extra cleave pressure, because I think they really need to work on getting that cross CC in a way so that they can secure those mana rifts and making it so that Fresh can never really break those out, because that's the only way that you're going to go through that Blessing of Wisdom. You have to consistently get your mana rifts, and if you ever get in a situation where you're missing them due to the Sanctuary, then that's when you start to fall behind. Now, Mao doesn't go for that Spirit Link on her talent this time to try to be as mana efficient as possible, and that's what this game is going to come down to.
Yeah, we'll see if that pays off, not being that Spirit Link talent at the same time. Wanfu getting a bit low. They do have the defensive cooldowns to survive, and again, both warriors playing those disarms, and they're going to be key to survive, and now we get that double stun CC from Mad Dog. The Hammer of Justice onto Mao P with the Stormbolt onto Wanfu, and just bursting him down, opting to go on him instead of the Demon Hunter, just because of uptime, really. So I think it's a smart choice. Oxygen using his Ascend. It's Fresh getting a bit low here, but he's just pumping out the heals. He should be okay. And the Urban Shield totems come out from both healers as well.
Yeah, and that Ascendance is up. That should keep them a little bit topped off. Now, the one thing that I do like maybe is hitting the Warrior instead of Dog Mage with those stuns, just because Dog Mage has that adaptation. So I think the only times they really want to touch him is when they know that they're going to get that good clean CC. Now, they force Dog Mage to use his reverse magic onto Fresh, and that they're actually turning around the pressure on him, forces Bubble with a really clean turnaround right there. I think maybe that could have been a mistake going for that Hodge at that moment, because that gave the opportunity for them to use that stun to get that counter pressure. And every time Dog Mage, we've seen him do it again and again, he uses a reverse magic, but he actually will cover the healer with that at the same time. And that is the smartest play I've seen from many, many Demon Hunters. They use that to turn it around onto their opponent, force cooldowns, and get the bubble from Fresh.
Yeah, Dog Mage is doing that excellently. If they hodge someone else, then he's just going to reverse magic them. So they really are forced to stun him, and they're doing a lot of pressure with this. And again, a stun Hex into a Fear onto Malpy. Dog Mage going to be in trouble. He has that Death from Above if needed, but he pops down the Darkness, which is that big defensive cooldown out of the way, as well as the Urban Shield Totem coming down from Malpy. So again, Mad Dog looking very strong.
Yeah, this is actually looking really good too, because of that last setup, they used the Intimidating Shout, and that got the adaptation from Dog Mage. So that means now they can go for that Hodge cover on him, but they have a ton of burst coming out, force the Spirit Link Totem to be used by Oxygen. Things are looking scary for them. They're not able to get that cross CC onto Dog Mage, and I love how Rock is actually finding his under pressure, but Juan gets bursted down, forced to use that Die by the Sword. He uses his parry, he used every defensive cooldown. Spirit Link comes out from Mao, but they're trying to turn the pressure on Yoski. Has to Die by the Sword. No bubble from Fresh. Both teams are so volatile here. There's a full Fel Eruption sent onto Oxygen, gets tanked out. They're trying to turn the pressure, trying to keep momentum from both sides, but it seems like they're both stabilizing. But no, Yosk is getting pressured once again. 50% HP. They're trying to keep that damage onto him. They have the full Hodge going out to Mao, trying to turn it around the pressure onto Dog Mage, get the full Hex on him, forcing the Trinket. They have the stun onto Fresh. No, double stun comes out. Yosk is getting bursted out. 20% HP. He has nothing. Oxygen gets out of the Hex. They break it from the cleave. That could have been a mistake.
Yeah, it could have been. The Overshield Totem comes down right now. Those two, they should be okay for now. Wanfu now taking a lot of pressure. And like we said, these melee cleaves, they just have a blood buff. As soon as the defensive goes wrong, or as soon as they get crowd control on their healer, they can just completely turn around the game with this defensive pressure. That Hammer of Justice was DR'd, so a bit of a mistake there from Fresh. And now Fresh has no defensive cooldowns, neither does Oxygen, so he could be in some trouble. Knowing that, he's kiting away excellently, but he's still getting very low on HP. Near that XP range, pops his own parry as well. Going on to Malpy right now, but he just uses that Astral Shift, trying to sneak in a Hex, but it looks like he's unable to get in it. Fresh just super low on HP. They use the Healing Tide, but will it be enough? Dog Mage getting low as well. I can't believe how low he is, and there it is. They finally finished Fresh, and it looks like they were able to just turn it around and get those rep pattern and cooldowns, and they
have brought it to the bigger, more spread out map, not feeling confident in close quarters. We'll have to see if Oxygen can play the mana game better on Tolveron.
It'll be interesting to see if Tolveron just gives them the advantage, because then in theory, Mad Dog will win on paper if they just can keep picking these larger maps to win. But we'll have to see if that's exactly what happens. Yosuke actually getting aggressive on the Shaman right there. Wanfu taking a lot of damage. Actually, swapping their trinket choices. Wanfu playing with that adaptation, Dog Mage with that trinket now. It's very interesting to see.
Yeah, I think that's good, because sometimes Dog Mage could get his adaptation force from an Intimidating Shout, so he wasn't always able to reverse magic sometimes, especially if he got Hodge himself. So this way he can have a trinket for those really dire moments. Plus when you're fighting that Rhett Paladin, you have the Wings that has a minute 30 cooldown, and this way, in case there's a full stun on you during the Wings by playing Gladiator's Medallion, you're safe with that. I think it's going to be a wise choice playing out into that longer game, especially because they realize that they're on Tolveron Arena. I don't think they're going to be able to have that same close quarters advantage that they had on Mad Dog in that smaller map. Plus Stormrunner Arena. They need to be really careful, but they have a ton of burst coming down to one, forcing them to use that parry right here. But no, they have damage going on to Fresh, trying to chunk him down. There is that full Fel Eruption Sun onto Oxygen, trying to burst down Fresh, forcing the bubble, maybe get the bubble from him. Beautiful play from Rock. They are getting a ton of pressure here with the Metamorphosis activated, and they're trying to keep up that momentum, swapping over to Oxygen, getting him to around half HP. He has no Earthen Wall available. It's going to be really hard for him. Now Fresh gets swapped back to. He can't pop himself. They have Ascendance being forced from Oxygen, holds onto the Spirit Link, holds onto his Gladiator's Medallions, but no. That in-cap breaks, I think it was just from the AoE damage. He might not be playing the undispellable version. That's very scary for them. And another nice interrupt comes out into Oxygen. They're trying to get a ton of pressure onto Fresh, forcing him very low. Triple stun comes down. They're going to burst out Fresh again, pop himself. They get the Trinket Spirit Link from Oxygen, and he saves his team for now.
Rock is forcing defensive cooldown after defensive cooldown for a minute straight, forcing the Spirit Link, the Trinket, Healing Tide, Ascendance, Bubble. Fresh almost has nothing, he just has the bop. And once again, nice pummels coming in from Dogmage every time, just locking down Oxygen and creating so much pressure on the Fresh. And Fresh is having a really hard time to survive right now. And they don't have anything left. They use the Hammer of Justice on the Dogmage. It gets the spell down immediately. No cross CC right there. Mad Dog are falling apart.
Fresh has nothing left. He had that bop used on himself, got instantly purged from Dog Mage with that Demon Hunter purge, and now Fresh is trying to run behind the pillar using his horse to run away, but Dog Mage can connect. He should have damage onto him. They have that fear coming out onto Oxygen, that there is no sync available. Fresh could get bursted down, pops the wings, trying to keep himself alive. He's a Word of Glory on himself, gets full Stormbolt. They're bursting him down. They could finish him. Oxygen has nothing left. He can't use that Earthen Wall. He's barely trying to hold on to Fresh's health. There's the darkness coming out from Dog Mage. They know that they just need to stay alive. They know they need to stop the Ret counter pressure with that Avenging Wrath. They just need to stay in this game. They use the Gladiator's Medallion from Mao. He's trying to keep himself, his team stable, but Mad Dog is in so much trouble. They could very well finish the game, and another triple stun comes out. Yossi is being pressured right now, swapping over to him, maybe forced to die by the sword, but no, seems like they're going to stabilize.
Yeah, Rock was all over them offensively. It's this long map in the total of everyone hasn't really stopped them at all. They just keep getting so much pressure against them, and now a disarm being used on the Yosuke. He also uses Rallying Cry, and there is this. The Urban Shield Tome coming out from Malpi. Wanfu actually in a lot of trouble right now. He's near that execute range. The leap and rally and cry come out. He could still just go down. They're just about clutching that Spirit Link from Malpi, and all of a sudden, Mad Dog have a strong comeback.
Yeah, Mad Dog had a beautiful cross CC setup. They had the full Hex going to Mal. They had the full Hodge going onto Wan. He had no adaptation. They didn't have the reverse magic range from Dog. I think he was caught into that that full route from Oxygen. So really nice play from him. He couldn't get over there in time, and they were able to finally burst him down. Wan just barely escaping with that heroic leap onto Mal. Just surviving just a little bit, giving Mal that time to get that Spirit Link off, and they still need to try to keep this momentum, because otherwise the pressure Rock has had has been phenomenal.
Yeah, it has really been excellent. And there's that double stun on the Fresh and Oxygen. They're bursting out on Yosuke. He actually uses the Dire by the Sword and the Trinket on the Storm, but a full Hex on the Oxygen. He still could be in trouble. This was a really good Dire by the Sword, but it might not be enough. Fresh just trying to off-heal as much as he can, knowing they need to survive right now. A triple fear comes out onto Oxygen as Fresh. They're still slaying Yosuke, completely destroying him through defensive stance. A DR sap, though, coming in from Oxygen. Malpi pushing in, looking for those wind shears, but now gets caught in that storm. But a nice wall banner defensively as well. Another beautiful kick from Dogmage onto Oxygen. He's been playing so well this game.
The swaps on each other's warriors is so beautiful, because with these intimidating shots, you're going to get so much pressure onto them, forcing cross CC. Now they have that full Hex from Oxygen. They need a burst down Wan here. He does have the Die by the Sword up on himself. If he can get stunned, though, by a Stormwall, he could go down. They don't have it available. Wan is trying to live. No, he gets bursted down. They could kill 2% HP, and they get the kill with the wings from Fresh.
All three members of Mad Dog were on the same page with that one, and beautiful cross control coming out of them. They got the Storm Bolt that got kicked, the Hex.
I think with that smaller map choice, it's not, nothing will compare to Dalaran Sewers as far as the Demon Hunter Warrior in this matchup, because you're forced behind the boxes there and you're forced to be stacked up. Whereas even this map, with it being small, the Shamans do not exactly have to play on top of each other. They still have some range that they can generate, which won't be as comparable. And we can actually see that Mao is deciding to swap back to that Spirit Link talent, maybe to try to avoid some of that burst damage, maybe going to try to just only use it when he thinks his team is in trouble, almost effectively like having the Spirit Link regular totem, but just having it more often. But he's actually using it quite frequently here, and they are getting a little bit more mana rift. So it is interesting to see them swapping back to that first game strategy, where they try to be a little bit more on the defensive side, realizing that there was a little bit too much pressure coming out. But we can actually see that Mad Dog is actually deciding to cleave a little bit and getting that momentum on all the players on Rock, and they're forcing a ton of pressure onto Dog Maze. They had that Fel Eruption coming out to Oxygen, getting that nice mana rift out of that as well, but immediately stun coming out for that cross CC onto Dog Mage and Mal, and they put pressure onto Wan. Might force his Rallying Cry or his Die by the Sword, but no, he holds onto it. They have a little bit of defensives left for them. They have pretty much everything available. They just don't have the Earthen Wall, which comes up in 10. but they have the darkness, they have the cooldowns, they should be able to stabilize themselves. And what they really have to be worried about is in a minute when that next set of wings comes up from Fresh, every single time we see that happen, especially once the games get longer and longer, that's when things get super scary.
Yeah, it can get very scary. And the Spirit Link actually comes out right away from Oxygen as well as the Ascendance right now. So huge burst pressure coming in from ROC there with that Warbreaker. Wanfu not only playing defensively well, but playing offensively as well, getting those defensive cooldowns. And Fresh in so much trouble here. The Imprison coming out onto Oxygen. It looks like he's going to actually force the bubble with that. So again, on the back foot, Mad Dog. But at the same time, they are ahead on mana.
Right, and they actually were able to force the darkness with that counter pressure. They got that full fear into the full hex, force the trinket out from Mal, get him in the full Hodge. Dog Mage needs to get there for the reverse magic, but he doesn't. And he gets Stormbolted, gets the reverse magic late. They have the Fell Eruption again to cover Oxygen, trying to get the pressure on Fresh, who has no bubble available for himself. In about 5 seconds, he should have that Blessing and Protection available with that Forbearance falling. He should have it up for himself, but they can purge it off. So if Dog Mage can connect, he is disarmed right now, trying to keep that momentum going. He's near Oxygen, trying to get a little bit of those mana rest, but Fresh has the wings back up. Now the pressure should turn in their favor. They have cooldowns left from Juan, but if they can pressure Dog Mage, he has no darkness available. They need to be very careful. They have the Spirit Link being repeatedly used to try to stop them from getting that extra damage output. But that means that Mayo is using pretty much all of his mana pool, and if they don't win the game quickly, this is where they're going to fall extremely behind, because they're using that as like an all-in out of desperation.
Yeah, they are, and they use that Urban Shield Totem as well as the Spirit Link to just deflect a lot of this Wings pressure coming out from Fresh. Another disarm as well. They really don't want him to keep cleaving them down. So Malby, yeah, falling further behind, and it's going to be hard. He needs to be able to keep his team alive to take out Fresh, but at the same time, Oxygen still has cooldowns. He's going to have the Overshield Totem coming very soon. Fresh still very low. The Wanfu trying to push in for the execute. He's playing with that charge execute, but he got bopped on it. So well played by Fresh to avoid that. And he gets topped off. And now, Rocker on the back foot. Malpy once again getting reverse magic onto that Hammer of Justice, but is using his mana pools on those Spirit Link talents. I'm not sure if they're going to be able to survive more.
They have the Earthen Wall here, so this is the last line of defense for Fresh. He has no Blessing Protection. He gets interrupted on his heals. He's trying to keep himself stabilized, but they have so much momentum right now in the favor of ROC. And they have Avatar coming up in just 5 seconds from Juan. I think if they go for a burst window here, they have that full Hex in auction. He does have the Gladiator's Medallion available, but they still have no real defenses for Fresh. So if they can get another burst setup, it's going to be scary for them. But no, they turn around the pressure. Double Stun comes out, trying to get the damage onto Mal. Triple Fear comes out. They're getting the damage onto Juan instead, trying to force his Die by the Sword, potentially. But it's not happening. They don't have enough damage at this moment. They have the Spirit Link active from Mal, so that's what's going to keep him stabilized. He has so much damage reduction that way. But this is forcing Mal to use so much of his mana pool. We can see the difference. Dampening should be starting in just a moment, I believe, by the time this next set of wings comes up. And that's when things get super, super scary, because Oxygen has about half of his mana pool, while Mal has nothing left, even with him being a little bit conservative with his Spirit Links.
Yeah, he has been very conservative, but yeah, like you said, completely out of mana. Very soon, the Stormbolt used onto him, Hammer of Justice on the Dog Mage. He has the Trinket if needs be, but a full Hex is secured. Surely he needs the Trinket. They're going to be in so much trouble if he doesn't. Dog Mage and Wampa getting super low. The Die by the Sword comes out right now, saving his Trinket, but again, a huge defensive cooldown. But now, Fresh taking so much pressure. Oxygen having the Trinket, Ascended Spirit Link again once.
He gets full Hex.
Such a blood buff, and he gets full Hex. Fresh could be in a lot of trouble now. All of a sudden, the tables have turned.
Yeah, and that was the end of the wings right there. He's using everything for himself. He's trying to just keep the momentum going onto Dog Mage, but if they get another cross crowd control, that's going to be huge for them. They go for the Stormbolt. They should have the Hodge back up, but no, Fresh is disarmed. He's not able to get that much damage output. He's trying to run away. They use the defenses to disarm onto Juan. They get a nice Cap Totem coming out from Oxygen, trying to get that pressure onto both DPS. Stormbolt goes onto Fresh. They get the Fell Eruption onto Oxygen. Cross CCing him. They need a burst, and they need to get the Hex coming out, but they do not have a follow-up Hex from Mal. Mal's pushing up. He's trying to get CC onto Oxygen, but no, next year, and they might turn it around and kill Juan. This could be it for ROC. They stay in the game. They're trying to keep the momentum going, and Oxygen has been expending all of his mana. He has nothing left. They have Ascendance available for Mal. He's trying to keep his team in the game, but it's just so scary for both these teams. A beautiful triple fear for him. Yas comes out. They could burst out Juan. They can't apply the Spirit Link. They have a Riptide coming out, saving his life just barely. Dog Mage low. Juan is low. He has the Avatar trying to get the cross pressure. He has the defensive fear going out with a nice full Fell Eruption onto Oxygen. They're staying in the game, but they're so low, and they have wings coming up in 40 seconds. They need to be so careful. They need to end it now. Both healers out of mana. 4% dampening.
The Overshield Totem comes out as well from Malby, and those totems are just so good for them to survive. I mean, like you said, Dog Mage and Wanfu were super low, and the Overshield Totems are just about keeping them alive, but both healers are completely out of mana. A nice Hex on the Malby. This could just be it. Wanfu's surely going to go down here. Beautiful pills from Wanfu with that disarm, but it's not enough, and that means that Mad Dog do take this 3-1.
Feed versus the fake Zebras. We're all tied up. 1-1. Who is going to find themselves on match point? Who is going to get a little bit further into this tournament? Keep in mind, folks, we're doing a brand new thing. You have just entered, in the middle of history, the longest series that has ever been played in Battle for Azeroth.